Hey guys, I'm back. This video is me answering all of you guys' blogging questions. So that's what I'll be doing today. You guys sent me a lot of good questions, so hopefully they're helpful, you know, for you guys to start your own blogging career and stuff like that. So yeah, let's get to it. Number one was, what editing program do you use for your videos? Currently, I'm very basic. Currently on my computer, I use iMovie just because it's the one that comes with a Mac and it's just easy. And it's kind of easy to do vlogs on there. I don't have to do a lot of like professional, you know, cuts and that sort of stuff. So that's what I use. I did used to use Premiere, and for me, I really enjoyed it. You can do so many cuts, you can make it really cool. Add so many different like layers, and just that I recommend if you're trying to be like pro, but obviously you have to learn how to use it because it's kind of hard. So I had someone kind of teach me a little bit of it, like the basics, and it was still a little bit hard. So for beginners, iMovie. If you're trying to do some more professional videography, then I would recommend Premiere. Number two is, do you use an editorial calendar? Personally, I don't have like a calendar. A month, I feel like it's just too far ahead to plan. But sometimes when I work with brands, they do want me to post on a certain day. So I'll just have it like that picture, you know, scheduled for that certain day. I do use apps that help me stay organized. So whatever new content I'll have, I do organize it. I would say maybe for a week. That's as far as in advance as I'll go, but for a month, no, I think that's a lot. Question number three is, how much time do you spend on work? I can't really give you an estimated time of work, just because I literally pretty much work all day. Like yesterday I woke up, I went to the gym, I started to work, I had to do some errands, and then I came back, I got ready. I went to go shoot at 1 p.m. And then after that, I hung out with my friend. But like, even though I was hanging out and we were going to be different places and eating out, I was still kind of technically working because I was still Insta-storing and vlogging. There's really not like from 8 to 5 I work, because it's just like I literally work all day, and then when I come home, I don't end up going to bed till like 12:30 because I'm always like, you know, editing or checking emails. So it's really just many hours that I spend on blogging. Even on the weekends, we still blog and shoot literally all day. I think last weekend we started shooting at like 11 or 12:30, and we didn't end shooting till like 5. So, and that was on the weekend. So yeah, it's pretty time consuming for sure. So how do you build relationships with brands? Do they reach out to you, or do you reach out? Most of the brands that I work with, they reach out to me. I get emails. I really do not have time to be like contacting companies and trying to send out my proposal. It's too much. You know, if companies want to work with me, they'll email me and then I'll get to it. So that's how, you know, I work. But I think if you're a beginner, even if you're not getting paid to do stuff, like just review products that you like, you know, just be truthful about that kind of stuff. And I think that's what I did at the beginning. I was so into beauty, and I did like makeup tutorials, and I kind of just posted pictures of like beauty products that I use. And just that gives like a company kind of an example of what a review for them would look like. And then building relationships with brands, I say, you know, once they reach out, you know, always have that quality content. Make sure you do the best, make sure you follow the guidelines, and just be kind, you know, even in your emails, be professional. And I think that's how you honestly build long-lasting relationships with these companies. Don't be difficult, and then just do what they're asking for. Next question is, what has been the hardest part of blogging and the business side of it? The hardest part, I would say that you really just don't have like a set time where you're just like, oh, well, let me just not work anymore. I think that's hard, because you always kind of have to work. Like, you're, as a blogger, it's like you're the brand. Your person is the brand. So it's like you can't turn off who you are, you know? It's like 24/7, you have to go, go, go. And then it's a lot of, sometimes it's just a lot of scheduling, a lot of planning. It's a lot of running around throughout the day. So that gets kind of hard and busy just because you get kind of overwhelmed. But for the business side of it, I would say the hardest part for me sometimes is when companies don't pay you on time or you just have to like harass them for them to pay you. I think that's so annoying. That's so unprofessional. Because I think a lot of businesses or companies, they'll reach out, you'll actually end up posting. Or if you don't post, they'll send out like millions and millions of emails like, you haven't posted, you haven't posted. But when it comes to the day that they have to pay you, it's like they're nowhere to be found. So I find that really annoying and obnoxious, and I hate that. So for the business side of it, I would say that that has been the hardest part. What is your favorite part when working with brands? My favorite part with working with brands is obviously when I get the product. I only take on things that I really believe in and like. So I love just like getting the product, getting it in the mail. I think it's like the most amazing, unpackaging it. Sometimes they'll leave letters. I think that's so fun. So I would say that's my favorite part. Obviously later on it's getting paid, but I think just reviewing the product in itself and or when it's closed and trying them on, it's just like, it's just so much joy. Just love it. How do you politely deny collabs that you're not interested in? Politely just, you know, say like, unfortunately at this moment, you know, if you're denying because they don't want to pay you, I'm always like, you know, I'm sorry, but I really am too busy with other sponsored stuff or people that are paying me. So unfortunately I'm going to have to pass this time. And if it's just something that like does not go with your brand and you don't want to like review it or whatever, then I just personally say, you know, it just doesn't go with my brand and who I am. And then you just deny. A lot of people just don't reply. And I think you should always reply because then they're going to keep emailing you and they're going to be like, hey, did you get this email? And they're going to be like following up for days. So I just say, just reply, politely decline, tell them your reasons and you're good. You don't have to give a whole explanation. Okay. Do you have a template that you use to reach out to companies? And how do you increase your audience as a beginner? I don't have a template to reach out to brands because I don't really reach out. When I do reach out, I'll actually really contact them through like a DM and I'll be like, hey, like if you're interested in collaborating, I love your brand and your company, I would love to. And then they'll send me the email and I'll just be like, hey, this is Danny from Little Mexico, you know, let's partner up. Basically, that's literally all I do. But how do you increase your audience as a beginner? Just do it organically. Use your hashtags. Make sure you're switching them around all the time. Don't use the same ones all the time because that's bad. And then just do whatever your brand is and whatever you want that to look like. So if you're blogging about beauty or fitness or whatever, just try to get the best quality out there. There's so many people out there blogging. So just don't be mediocre, be the best. Really just have quality content. People do stuff that people want to see, you know, provide a solution for stuff. Yeah, that's what I would say. You know, also I think when you're beginning, engage, make a lot of good connections with other bloggers and other people that are doing the same thing as you. Connect, engage, go live, you know, comment on people. And I think that's really how you increase your following organically. Don't buy followers, don't do a million and one giveaways because that's annoying. But yeah, so those were some of the questions that you guys sent me. I hope that was a little bit helpful. I can always do a part two of this video. If you have any other questions, just comment them below and I'll be sure to answer them or email you and answer them. But most likely I'll do a part two of this video. So thanks guys for tuning in. I'll see you guys next time. I love y'all and yeah, that's it.